Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ikra bismi rabbika allazi khalaq. Khalaq al-insana ma'alak. Ikra wa rabbuka al-akram allazi alama bil-kalm. Alama al-insana ma'alam ya'alam. Translation is, read in the name of thy Lord who created man from a clot of congealed blood. Read, and thy Lord is most bountiful, who taught the use of the pen, taught man that which he knew not. Quran, it is, these are the ayahs from Quran, ayah number 96, I suppose. The revelation of the divine message, which continued for the next 23 years, had begun. And the Rasul had arisen to proclaim the oneness of Allah, Tawheed, and the unity of mankind. His mission was to destroy the nexus of superstition, ignorance, and disbelief, and set up a noble conception of life and lead mankind to the light of faith and divine bliss. Since this belief was threatening their dominance in the society, the pagan Arabs started to mount pressure on Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers. They wanted them to renounce their cause and take to idol worshipping. On one occasion, they sent a delegation to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam's kind and caring uncle Abu Talib. They told him to restrain the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam from preaching Allah Almighty's message or face their enmity. Finding himself in a dilemma, he sent for his nephew and explained to him the situation. The Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam responded with these memorable words: "My dear uncle, if they put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left, even then I shall not abandon the proclamation of oneness of Allah, Tawheed. I shall set up the true faith upon the earth or perish in this attempt." The Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam uncle was so impressed with his nephew's firm determination that he replied, "Son of my brother, go thy way. None will dare touch thee. I shall never forsake thee." And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam did go the way Allah Almighty had chosen for him. Imbued with divine guidance and firm resolve, the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam encountered all the challenges with grace and dignity. In no time, he elevated man to the highest possible level in both spiritual and worldly domains. He was also a divine force behind the Arab conquests, which have created an everlasting impression on human history. No wonder he is universally acknowledged as the most influential figure in history.